Are you afraid of height? That's perfectly normal. Today, I will show you how to work safely at height, according to the GWO Basic Safety Training Standard. Watch till the end. The skills can save lives. My name is Dmitry Silankaev. I'm a professional rock climber and industrial climber. Let's start. First, let's go through personal protective equipment. You need to understand what each component is for. Base, the harness. You put it on to attach all following equipment on you. Power rest lanyards. They attach to the ladder for safe climbing. Work positioning allows you to fix yourself in place and work with both hands. Sliders. With them you can climb by the ladder, providing another layer of safety. Swings. Used to create anchor points. And finally, the rescue device. It will help you descend in emergency case of situation. You will see exactly how it works during the exercises. This equipment is a basic foundation for working in height. Now that we covered it, let's move on to the practical exercises. The most common task for wind turbine workers, onshore and offshore crews, is climbing up and down the ladder. It's simple. We use power rest lanyards like this through every other rung. As soon as your chest reaches the level of the upper lanyard, you move the lower one up, and the same goes when descending. Evacuation from height. Let's go over the key steps to descend safely. Step number one. Secure yourself with the fall rest lanyard not to fall down. Make sure that the anchor point is safe. To prevent dropped objects, we need to secure the device with a hook. And now we can connect to the anchor point our device. Now we need to block the device. How to do it? We need to put the rope on one ear, after in a special slot, and spin rope around 3 times. Now we need to drop the bag. After we drop the bag, we can connect yourself to the harness and take off your lanyard. Now we're ready. We need to unbox the device. And one ear need to stay. Now we can go down. When working in a team, you might need to rescue your partner if he lost consciousness on a ladder. Time is critical and you need to act fast. If you don't begin the evacuation immediately, after 15 minutes the blood vessels may become compressed and this could end in tragedy. Rescue is done step by step. Make sure that you have all necessary equipment with you. Climb above the casualty using fall rest lanyards. Now we need to position yourself with work position in lanyard. Next step, we need to create anchor points. Now, I need my rescue device, but I need to connect it in the back with the hook. Now I need to put rescue device in an active mode to the anchor point. Prepare the device for descending. You need to put one ear and a special slot inside, and rope will go down. After you prepared, you can connect it to yourself. Don't forget to disconnect four rest lanyards and work positioning lanyard. Now we're ready to go down. When we on one level with casualty, we need to secure the device by spinning the rope 3 times upper wheel. Now I need to use 2 connectors to connect the casualty to the device. Now we need to unblock the wheel, and by rotating the wheel, we need to pull up the casualty to disconnect all his equipment. We need to block the device. Now we can disconnect all his equipment. And now we're ready to go down. These 3 exercises give you a solid foundation in working at high training. I hope you find this video helpful. Thanks for watching, and see you at Novikontas.